It's hard to believe almost a year has gone by. The world was glued to their TVs, shocked by the images and the destruction. And the world responded with an outpouring of help. But they also wondered, when will it all stop? When will Haiti catch a break? The most recent crisis for Haitians? Cholera. And Marie just came down with it. She just arrived at this health center CRS supports in northern Haiti. Her son and nephew had carried her on an old door from Debroche, her hilltop village more than an hour away. La Martine and his sister, Victoire, were worried. They weren't sure if their mom would make it to the health center. They knew that cholera can kill in a matter of hours. Thanks to campaigns by the government and humanitarian organizations like CRS, word has gotten out. Haitians know about cholera and how to prevent it with basic hand washing. Still, Blaise Fattener is worried. He oversees CRS's cholera response in the area. He's concerned about cholera spread to Haiti's rural villages that are far from health centers. Hundreds of Haitians have come to this center since the epidemic started. In November, the center was receiving more than 20 people a day. While the number of cases per day has dropped, more Haitians are arriving now from remote villages. Blaise and I decide to visit Marie's village. On the way, we came across another man, also from Debroche, who had fallen sick that morning.
C'est cholera?
Oui.
Tu viens d'où? Quel village?
Villagers were rushing him to the health center. It took us more than an hour to walk to Debroche. Most of it was straight up a mountain. Once we got to the top, Edith, Marie's daughter, told us the details of her illness that morning. Then Victoire took us down to the stream to get water. The water isn't clean, but Victoire and everyone else downstream gets it from here because there's no piped water in the village. With the outbreak of cholera, Victoire now treats the water with Aquatabs, which are capsules that purify it. CRS provided them to her and other families in the area. Now, she says, her family never drinks untreated water. Victoire doesn't know her mom contracted cholera, but she knows that washing her hands with soap can prevent it. CRS has handed out thousands of bars of soap and Clorox to treat water. We also gave Marie and her family oral rehydration solution. Marie drank that on the way down the mountain. If she hadn't, she might not have made it. On the way home, Blaise and I stopped to see Marie. She was doing better. She'd gone through 5 bags of intravenous solution. It looks like she's going to be all right.